What's going on YouTube? It's your boy Vinny D for your COD Authority website update. Guys, it's been over a month since my last video. I said that I would focus on the website. I am launching a video now. I'm just going to freestyle this video. We got a lot of things I want to cover. And before we jump into the weekly recaps that you guys want to see, I do want to take the attention and I need both the Xbox and the PlayStation players to give me your feedback on what you think I should be doing here. For the longest time right now, we've had the number one guy on the Xbox side who's been, Twitch Mad TV. Obviously, it's a shared account. He's 100%, legit. Obviously, nobody's close to him in points for the time played, etc. However, over the course of the past week, he was finally gaining ground on a booster. Okay, so as you can see here, he's 5 million points back last week. This week, he took measures to pass that booster, so he put in 5 million points. It's not going to continue, but it was still, it's still cheating to get up there. I mean, you could have worked your way to get to that 5 million, eventually pass him, but you decided on doing it within a course of a week. So because of that, he was removed this week, and it hurts to do it. But at the same time, you guys need to understand that when I say that I need to stick to my guns, if somebody's boosting and I don't see it and it's not clear cut, then fine. But I mean, when you get messages from 20 people and your eyes are peeled on the top guys, you really need to watch out what you do, because then I'd be falling back on my word and giving free passes to everybody. So this is your call, guys. If you think that, he should be reinstated because it was 1 week and it was to pass a booster, and that won't happen again, then I'll reinstate him. And I feel bad removing him. Mad TV, it's nothing against you, man, but I just need to follow protocol, because there's 100 other people that sometimes it takes them a month to put up 5 million points. So the next question is, on the PlayStation side, again, guys, 30 more seconds, we have Forever Shredded, who is number one, Golden Boy. And the question comes up where he's a spawn trapper. He shouldn't be there either. Forever Shredder wasn't on the leaderboards early on, and you guys, the top guys, have mentioned that he is legit. He should be put on. He's a 100% legit guy percent. And then he came out with a video trying to grow his channel, how to spawn trap, where he clearly goes over, massive amounts of points, just modding people over here, and that kind of turned people the wrong way. But he never hit it. I mean, he did show how to spawn trap. Was his points made out of that? No, not necessarily. There's the excuse of, like, the two top guys. We have Mad TV and we have Forever Shredded. So I need your opinion, guys, on what you think I should do here. Again, I took action on removing Mad TV, and if he's going to be reinstated, it's going to be by you guys. If you're shy to put it up in the comments, you could always hit me up. My gamer tags, COD Authority for both sides. Let me know what you guys think. Again, I don't like removing people, especially when you work hard and you're at the top. But it's not just about the number one and number two guys in the world. There's 98 other guys out there grinding. So what's fair is fair. Anyway, thanks for that. Let's get into the overview on what we're going to be talking about today. Again, I'm just going to freestyle this video. We're going to go over it. COD Authority website updates. Fortnite, just a quick recap. I want to give you my 2 cents on certain things. The weekly recap, for Xbox and PlayStation, and future plans. So if at any time you want to fast forward to your corresponding parts of the video, go right ahead. So first off, the website itself, as I had said, I had been working on, right now, because of the lack of content with World War II, I don't want to put too much change into the website, because obviously it costs me money and there's no money coming in from the website. So it's really made for you guys. So I need to pick what I want to do. What I added here over the course of the last 3 weeks was the social links. Okay, if you have a Twitch account or a YouTube account and you're actually gaming on it and you want this thing live, let me know what the channel name is, and again, through my gamer tag, just hit me up this way and I will put it next to your name. And how this is supposed to work, or how it does work, is if you have your account and you're online, like let's say Online Bully over here, if you're live streaming, it will go red. If you're live streaming on Twitch, it will go purple. Okay, so I put just the guys here who I knew off by hand. However, there's other guys out here that might have channels. As you can see over here, look, Mr. Thumbs, he's live streaming right now. So I'll just show you guys. I'm sure you've touched it before. Boom, he's live streaming, okay? So it's just to give you guys added exposure. If you have a channel and you want it up here, please hit me up. I will have no problem putting that next to your names on the social side. I just filled in what I could right now. So that's it for the actual changes. I'm also going to be creating a bulletin board where I could give you guys updates on exactly what's happening. But again, I'm treading lightly right now just because of lack of content with World War II. You know, maybe make more changes for Black Ops 4. However, I just continue to update the weekly leaderboards for now. Again, if you guys have any ideas that you'd like to see that you know you think would be cool for the website, I'm all ears. Please let me know. So again, going over, so that was for the website updates. Fortnite. Now I want to talk about Fortnite. Again, for the guys who are, you know, into monetizing YouTube channels, streaming, it's a no-brainer right now that Fortnite is just, you know, crushing it in every aspect of YouTube. There's so much money to be made right now, guys. I mean, I work on a lot of YouTube channels with clients. This is the COD Authority channel is just something that is to have fun and present the players with it. I don't take anything seriously with the YouTube channel, but I know how YouTube works very well because of the people I work with. And I'm just sorting right now. I'm going to give you guys an example. This is filtered over the last hour. Okay, so if you just, you know, you guys could do this yourselves. You look over the views, you know, like 4,000 views, 500 views, you know, like it's, you know, 36,000 views. And look at the quality of the thumbnails also, okay? The clickbait, not just clickbait, but the creativity of the thumbnails that you could create through Fortnite. Now let's look at a Call of Duty filter over the past hour, okay? For many of you guys that are running on Call of Duty. Now you could just see it's gray, there's no views. I mean, you can't compare, I'm not here to compare Fortnite to Call of Duty. You can't compare 50 million users, you know, to 20 million users and something that, you know, the supply and demand, it's crazy right now. However, you guys who have YouTube channels need to start thinking long and hard about transitioning over early in the game now. Early in the game, there's still a lot of room to make money through Fortnite. So I thought I'd throw that out there. I have a couple of friends who've moved over, but they didn't move over like half and half, like some Call of Duty, you know, some Battlefield, some Fortnite. They pulled the plug on the Call of Duty stuff. Sure, they still grind the boards, but their channels now are focused on Fortnite and just growing it that way. So they split their time. I just thought I'd throw that out there because I see a lot of you guys grinding, the Call of Duty, trying to build your channels. Hey, you know, I'm not taking away the love of the game. Call of Duty will still always be number one. However, you know, again, the supply and the demand for Fortnite right now is it's unbelievable. So there's huge, huge potential. And you guys need to get into the game now because all you guys in the top 100 play a lot of, you know, put a lot of time into gaming. So maybe figure something out, split your time off, and, you know, break it up. Look at Optics Gump. Even he's running Fortnite videos now. He knows where the money's at. So again, if you need to know more, I don't want to make this a YouTube video talking about Fortnite or other how to monetize YouTube, but I thought I'd throw that out there. Let's jump into the weekly recaps. We'll go over Xbox, we'll go over PlayStation, then we'll look at the the future plans of the website. So it's been a while since I haven't created a weekly recap. And the phone's ringing right now, 1 second. It's been a while since I haven't created a weekly recap. Like I said, it was getting a little stale doing it every week. So I let a month go by. Obviously, every Sunday night, I do extract the stats still. I do the same thing as I always done, 8 o'clock. This week for PlayStation was a little bit later. I had to run an update. So let's just go over a couple of things for the Xbox cut for the week. Right now, what you're seeing right here, 10.8 million. This is the rank 100. So for the guys that are out of the 100, how far off are you from this? That'll determine how far off you are from cracking the top 100. Here's number 100 right here. So again, you know, some change going on the Xbox side. A lot of the usual names are still here, but as we scroll down, you're going to see less and less of the guys with a longer history. Again, weeks on board, how many consecutive weeks you've been in the top 100, you're going to see the drop off. As we drop down, you see less and less of the guys 10 weeks plus, and you see more of the newcomers, which is perfectly normal. So, you know, 1 to 20, same concept. You're looking at around an average of a million points. It's a little bit low this week. Why? Because a lot of the, you know, there's four or five guys that haven't played any time this week, and because of that brings the average down. But you're looking at around a million points average for the top 20. That's not very, you know, it's not one of the stronger weeks, but it is what it is. You know, the same names as usual, four War Ninja, six Atomic Mountain, you know, same guys that are here all the time, who put in huge amounts of time. Look at this, 40 days played, 41 days played. War Ninja is always 2 days every, you know, every week. That's a lot of time played, and I've mentioned them before, but I mean, it is what it is. Recognition. I don't always look at scores and, you know, how much points you're putting in a week. That doesn't always impress me. It's guys that over the long period of time really like grind the game. It's hard to stay focused and, you know, religiously bound to a game. So props to you there. Behold Zach, obviously, you know, 7 weeks on the board, higher SPM for the top 20, and you know, very, very dangerous to reckon with. He knows exactly what he has to do when he plays a game, plays for points, rolls with the right people. So I mean, this is somebody who's on top of his points. He knows what he's doing, and again, rank 11, you know, 7 weeks on board, but with this high SPM and understanding the point system, somebody who I'm looking to, you know, crack into the top 10 very shortly, especially with the guys not playing over here. A couple more notables over here. Deuce XP jumped six spots, was 18, now 12. Again, 2 days and 15 hours played. It's a huge week. You know, 2 million points played. Excellent, excellent work. Number 18, Milk and Cookies, been around for a while. You know, again, two days, 13 hours played, 1 million points, a little bit of a lower SPM, but still, needless to say, 1 million points put in. So top 20, as you can see, a lot of green. That's because of Mad TV being removed, but not much flip-flopping here. A couple of spots here and there, but nothing too dramatic. From 21 to 40, the average goes down a little bit, but it's still pretty strong. You're looking at an average around 800,000 points from 21 to 40. Million points between 21 and 40, if your name is in here. A million points is a nice number to go for weekly. You know, it's a solid number, as you can see here, a million points. You know, it brought Killa up three slots. So it's a healthy number, a million points. The average is 800,000, but work it. A couple of guys to keep an eye on here, Jova XBL. You know, again, big SPM, big jump. You know, a day and 20 hours played, when you have a 524 SPM, 2.2 million points put in, like, that's trending upwards, and that's trending upwards in a hurry. So I'm not going to get into game modes right now, but you know, obviously with shipment domination being back, if you could stomach the fact of playing the same map over and over and over again for points, then the top guys know what they're doing, and they're just gonna, you know, bring in as many points as they can. Just keep finding that loophole in shipment and slamming the hell out of the map. So you got to do what you got to do for points, and that's up to you guys. Slugs, over here at 32, nice jump, 12 slots, lower SPM, almost 3 days played. Wow, 1.4 million score, so props to you there. Commend you back over here at 34, you know, a million points, almost 2 days played. You know, it's nice to see the guys that have only been on the board for 5 weeks here. You know, he's pretty much of a newcomer, so you could see he's putting in the time. And I mentioned that in previous videos, guys, like, just when you crack into the top 100, if somebody, you know, plays a day and a half, 2 days, and has been doing that week in and week out, you'll just climb. It's only a matter of time. And here's a perfect example of somebody who, you know, almost puts in 2 days a week. Even though it's the lower SPM, he's putting in his million every week. And look, after 5 weeks, he's up in the top 50. So congrats for that. Number 40, Prankster, another newcomer 5 weeks on, was 53, is now at number 40. So a nice leap over there. Again, the magic number of a million points. So as you can see here, it made him climb, you know, 13 spots, which is nice. An hour and 12, a day and 12 hours played. You know, from 40 to 80, I'm going to kind of spread it out a little bit instead of going from 40 to 60. 40 to 80 is 600,000 point average, a little bit down from the 800,000. And this is where, you know, you kind of see, you know, if the trending downwards is just because guys are not putting in as much time, or the 600,000 is not there. So you'll kind of see a mixed bag of red and green here. Then now you start looking into the guys that put in the time, you know, like, are they playing 18 hours, or are they playing 2 days? You guys have access to this. You can go and take a look. Again, I always say break it down by who's on top of you and who's below you. And that's the best way to gauge where, you know, exactly where you have to be and where you're going. So couple of notables over here at 58, Swift Ain't Easy, you know, was 72. Here you go, million points. If the average is 600,000, this guy just doubled it up, and it doesn't lie, he just jumped 14 slots at the same time. So nice jump over there. 65, Vampish Nickel, you know, only 3 weeks on the board, million points, 2 days played. Again, I keep going back to the days played, because that's where the that's where you find out and see if somebody's serious or not, and how long they're going to be around for. So good work there. At number 80, I am your bro. I am you, bro. Excuse me. Ninth slot jump. Only 2 weeks on the board. 800,000. Pretty much of a newcomer. And 72 and 76. I just wanted to go back to these two guys because they're pretty familiar. Kill Chain over here. 2 weeks on the board. Look at this leap over here. Was 95. Is now 72. You know, 2 days, 7 hours played. And we're here at 76. Shallow win. 2 weeks on the board. Was 99. Is now 76. 2 days and 8 hours played. Again, when you crack into the top 100, it's hard to see, you know, who's going to be, you know, where they're going to end up. I always say, are they one and done, or are they somebody who's cracking into the top 100 and now are going to be there to stay? Number 66, I had a fix I had to do over here. Sorry. Number 56, Enforcer, I've got to fix up these stats, as you can see here. If you guys ever see anything on a negative, just let me know and I'll clean that up. I noticed that before. So 40 to 80, that's pretty much it. You know, a little bit of a mixed bag. You have a lot of the, you don't see as many of the weak on boards. You see more of the newcomers. Again, you know, now 4 months over plus into the game, things have changed a lot from when we started. So, you know, and things are going to change a lot as we move forward. So again, this is, it's nice to see, you know, the new guys coming in, and it's excitement for the new guys cracking in, because I know a lot of you guys work hard at it, and you let me know personally. So congratulations on that. From 81 to 100, we've got you know, seven new guys on board this week. And yeah, you know, like seven in, seven out. So if you see here, the ones, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, new to the board, you know. And are they here to stay? This is where I go and I take a look at, you know, the time played. When somebody cracks into the top 100, I go and I go and take a look and I say, okay, this guy 28 days played, you know, Shell, he's not like a one and done. He's probably going to be sticking around. You know, I'll go and take a look over here, 25 days played. So 29 days played, Sugar. These are things to, these are kind of benchmarks for me to understand what I'm looking for and you know, where this person's going. So you see a little bit of a drop off here of a lot of guys that haven't been playing, or the numbers are a little bit down. For the top, from 80 to 100 guys, you're looking at around 450,000. That hasn't really changed much from like over the last couple of months. It's usually, you know, if you're bringing 500,000 points in this bracket, you know, that's good. And I always say, if you're outside of the top 100, look to be pushing for 500,000 points. As you can see here, the numbers are much lower than what they were when we were looking at, you know, from 20 to 40 and 40 to 60. So that's it for the Xbox side of it. Again, you know, it's numbers are a little bit down despite the shipment and all that, but it is what it is. You know, guys are jumping onto other games. They come and go, but the usual names are here. They seem to be sticking around, and we've got some new names coming in that we'll be keeping an eye on. So congratulations for that. Let's move over to the PlayStation side of it. PlayStation side is always the stronger console. I mean, I'm not gonna sit here and deny anything. The, you know, it seems like the competitive side is always on the PlayStation side, and that's been there from the beginning. More players, the quality, it's just different. So from 1 to 10, you know, welcome to shipment. These guys understand. If you look at the number of the points put on here, these guys understand how to monetize and how to use shipment to the, your, you know, just keep playing it over and over again and crack the points and bring it up and milk it, you know, milk as much as you could get. So, and here's a perfect example of it. Lead Dom, 3.4 million points, 2 days, 4 hours. Never would you see this on Domination without shipment there. But if it's there, you know, take advantage of it. So the top 20 is kind of flip-flopping right now. Nothing really huge. I mean, a couple of spots in and out, but you don't see really much, you know, dramatic drops or dramatic changes. I think the interesting thing here is that the guys that are like, for this PlayStation side, the top 20 guys who've been on the boards for 15 weeks, as you could see here, they don't really let up. I mean, 15 weeks, that's when we started. And you could see here, out of the top 21, like, it's practically everybody there. So it's not guys that have come and dropped out. They, you know, they're here and they take it seriously, and they're going to continue putting up the numbers. Probably the newest guy over here is Sanchos, at 16. You know, 9 weeks on board, 2 million points. You know, 3 days played. There's your answer right there. But everybody besides that has a long history. From 1 to 20, 21 to 40 is, you know, a million point average over here. That's what you're looking for. Still very strong compared to what the Xbox side is. So 21 to 40, you're looking at around a million points. Some of the notables over here, Gio Coco, 22, was 28. 2.4 million points, exactly how to be utilizing points. He knows what he's doing. 2 days and 13 hours played. 29, Dustin, probably one of the best snipers on the PlayStation side. Was 35, is now 29. 12 weeks on the board. Again, 2 million points put in. So as I said, with the 1 million point average, you are going to jump. So you move down a little bit. I mean, the trend doesn't really die off all that much. Over here at 36, the Akitaja, 1, 2, 3. 36 was 49, 1.6 million points. Nice week. Good SPM. So I've mentioned him before. And there's a little bit of a mistake over here. I got to clean up. Is Judy 5'11", 30. I don't know what went on over here. There was it was a backtrack. So I've got to clean this up. There's a problem with the numbers here. I noticed that when I was going over the scores. So as you can see, again, you know, we have a couple of other leaps over here, Mr. Thumbs. But nothing overly alarming. A couple of nice jumps, but I mean, pretty healthy. PlayStation, you're not going to go like on the Xbox. So you're not going to jump 20 spots in a week. It's too competitive. Even after, you know, taking a month off from creating my videos, I can still come back in here and look and say, okay, it's the same people, same amount of scores, you know. Not easy to crack and move ahead of people. You really need to put in the time, or you need to figure out your scoring system. So 41 to 80. 41 to 80 is a little bit different. I said 21 to 40, you're looking at around a million points. 41 to 80, I would say a million points is your golden number. Let's take a look at 41 over here, Mr. Thumbs. You know, a million points, look, he jumped 9 spots. So you're looking, all these guys that hit over 1 million points, as you can see, they've jumped here. They probably jumped between 8 and 10 spots. So a million points is the number you're looking for if your rank is between, if your position is between 41 and 80. And just look at the million points and it won't lie. You know, like I said, I gave these as an example. Thunder Knives over here, eight slot jump, a million points, 1.4 million points. Here we go. Look, 17 slot jump over here, 1.2 million points, 10 point jump. So there's your million. And the list goes on over here. Jesper over here, 13 point jump, 1.1 million points. So the million points is what you're gunning for from 41 to 80. Nice. I got to give props over here because this is a huge climb over here. 19 slots, the mark of a hero. See, I actually have his social links here. Again, guys, if you have your channels and you want me to put them up there, hit me up. Hit me up through the through PlayStation. I will add them for you, no problem. I just don't have the time to start digging and figuring out who has channels and who doesn't. But mark of a hero, nice jump over here, 19 slots. I thought I'd mention that. Number 66, again, Val, I need to fix this account also. As you can see here, it's on a negative, so the database was tweaked. So I apologize for that, Val. And that's pretty much it. A couple of newer faces you'll see here. You'll see less of the guys that have been on the boards for 10 to 15 weeks. You'll see some of the newcomers coming in. You know, guys that have been here 4 or 5 weeks. 4 is pretty much the magic number, so whether they're climbing or dipping is to be seen. You kind of see a little bit of red. You also see it's either you're jumping. This is like a cool bracket between 40 and 80 because it's either huge leaps or it's just guys like trending downwards. But you don't see many guys quitting on the game or not playing as much as you do on the Xbox side. What I mean by that is when you see the zeros, guys not putting in, like not playing for a week, you see a lot less than you would see on the Xbox console. So guys play and, you know, not many people just don't put in any time. It's pretty healthy on the PlayStation side, and it's always been healthy since the beginning. 81 to 100, again, the newcomers, we have seven new people jumping in, exact same as the Xbox side. And it's always been like that for around PlayStation. So congratulations for the guys who cracked it to the top 100. I know a lot of you work at it, and what I do here is once you get into the top 100, I start looking at the times played. You know, how many days played. So this guy over here, 31 days played. That kind of gives me an indication that he's somebody who's going to continue to trend upwards. And, you know, the lower time played is to be seen. And are they in 1 week and out the next? That's where we're going to basically determine if this guy's here to stay or not. You'll see more of the guys here just putting in less time if they've been here. You know, Da Vinci Code, 2 hours played, 1 hour played, Nomad Knight. Again, you know, could be just could just be moved on to another game. Just could be that he's just didn't put in the time this week. But usually that's what you're going to see between 81 and 100 is just the time played, really. You don't see big numbers. And the guys that do get into the 100, into the top 100, start putting in a lot of time. Also over here, Omaha, who's been on board for 6 weeks. You know, this guy, he grinds, he holds his little bit of lower SPM, but it's been holding into the top 100, which is hard to do. So he's always like borderline between 80 and 100, but it's hard. It's like it's nerve-wracking when you know you're close to that 100 and you got to stay above it. So congratulations over here. Look, a day and a half, 5 hours played, which is a lot for somebody at the bottom over here. We have Korean over here at rank 82, 13 hours played, and that's it. I mean, Xbox and PlayStation, very, very different when you look at the stats and the numbers. A lot of the top guys play for points. A lot of guys just grind the right maps. They know exactly what they need to do, and we'll keep it going. I mean, it's entertaining. It doesn't take me much time anymore. I pretty much have it down packed. And again, if there's any type of boosting or cheating, you know, always feel free. If you're shy in the comments, hit me up directly. I'll just put up my tags again over here. You know, it's a no-brainer. COD Authority on the Xbox and the PlayStation side. There are a couple of, Armin over here. I keep going back to him. I've been going back to him for a long time right now with this war mode and how things just don't add up, but I can't put my finger on it. So that's somebody who I'd like to know a little bit more on. If anybody has any intel, I've reached out to a couple of people to find out. Again, I'm not here to try to crack down on boosters. That's not the thing. I want to, bring you guys, like I said, your popcorn at your movie theater, just added value to what you're currently doing. But at the same time, the closer you get into the top 10, then I gotta kind of keep my eyes peeled and look out for things. So that's it. I know it's been a while, as I'd mentioned that I've released a video, one long video. And again, if you guys have any ideas on what you'd like to see with the website, again, I don't want to throw in too much money towards it if it's gonna go to waste. Because of the lack of content with World War II, I've kind of been hesitant on how much I'm gonna put, how much time I'm gonna put into it. Do I wait for Black Ops 4 to push more on the website? That was the decision I made. So I'm all ears again, either through the comments or hit me up directly. If there's anything, I'm here for you guys, and I'll continue to provide your weekly updates and throw a video out once in a while. I am going to be creating a bulletin board so that when you guys log into the website or hit the website, if I have any type of news to give you guys, a little pop-up will come here with some information. All right. So enjoy the game. It's nice to create a video again. I was just freestyling it. It was good to be back and get in touch with all the guys who are following the top 100. Keep up the good work, guys. Enjoy the game. And if there's anything, like I said, always reach out to me. Feel free, and I'm here for you. All right. Peace out, guys. Until next time.